Hi guys, so this time on Stay Tuned to Our Planet, we are calculating how many mobile phones we've had in our lifetimes. Riley is the winner. He's had 8 phones in 7 years. Now, is that impressive or is it terrifying? And it's not just phones, you know, there's things like laptops, gaming consoles, fans, heaters, drones, headphones. And once they're produced, there's more CO2 emitted from shipping the electronics all over the world. Components like integrated circuits, speakers, and screens are made from heavy metals like gold, cobalt, and lithium. The extraction of these metals, often through mining, causes pollution. And then they go to landfill. This is an issue because Australians throw out, on average, 20 kilograms of electronics each year per person. In 2022, on a global scale, 5 billion phones were thrown away. Here's the upside though, a lot of these electronics can be fixed. So let's chat to some of the good guys. The Bower Reuse and Repair Centre is one of many locations around Australia where you can have your old electronics made new again. And Othy is the electronic repair facilitator and runs workshops on how to fix stuff. If Othy can't fix it, they'll turn it into something else. Hi Othy. What exactly is an electronic repair facilitator?
For the last 5 years, I've been working in repair cafes, repairing kind of all kinds of things from starting off with bicycles and then getting into electrical repairs at the Bower. When people come down, we have half an hour to kind of diagnose it, pull it apart together, understand like how it might work. Every object is different, and if it is a really simple fix, they can do that themselves.
Do you find that a lot of the issues that arise are like actually really simple and people are ready to throw stuff out for things that can be easily fixed?
Yeah, like super frequent. I think people have a lot of fear around electronics. So they go like, I can't take this apart because I don't want to get electrocuted, which is really, really valid. So that's why we focus on empowering people to take things apart carefully and safely, just so they can see inside and understand how it works.
Would you say that ends up kind of diverting a lot of stuff from landfill too?
That's the idea, that's the dream, diverting landfill.
And is there like a relief sense almost from the climate change angle as well? Does it help you there?
Yeah, I definitely have climate anxiety and I see repair as like a deep part of my activism. It is really grounded and personal, but also in a community sense. If extraction stopped tomorrow, which would be great, it would really help the climate collapse. I think there'd be a lot more repair shops because we would have to be really taking care of all the materials that are currently in possession of humans.
Some of the reasons that new phones are purchased are for things like better battery life, updated security, or a broken screen. But fixing these issues doesn't necessarily mean you have to buy a whole new phone. And if you do buy a new phone, you can donate your old one to places like World Phone Amnesty, who'll refurbish, recycle, or even rehome your old phone. This is all part of a revolution called circular economy, which really challenges the notion that materials, products, and resources have an end of life. So do you fix phones over there as well?
We don't fix a huge amount of phones because people take it to people who are dedicated phone repairers. There's like specific tools of like microscopes and micro screwdrivers and stuff like that.
What do you fix that?
You just look around whatever room you're in right now. It's full of electronics that are going to break, whether it's your treasured console or just the fan that keeps you cool on a hot day. We have them brought down to us. And if I teach someone to open up something safely, the little tiny fixes they do in their house, that means that they don't throw something away.
So like for someone who might be new to it, would you encourage people to check out things like online tutorials?
Definitely. I use it all the time, every day in the repair shop. The internet is so essential to spreading knowledge.
I worked in tech and somehow I'm still unfamiliar with the e-waste process. So if you can't fix it, what do you do with it?
Ooh, good question. In terms of electronics, I think it's really important to take things to e-waste where they take out the elements and kind of try to recycle it as best they can.
Well, it's been wonderful talking, Othy. I really appreciate your perspective and all the good work you do. So thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us.
Yeah, thank you for your time.
Okay, so what are we doing? Well, instead of buying new electronics, look at your old ones and see if they can be fixed. You could even like organize a school collection of old phones and electronics and make sure they're recycled instead of thrown out. You could do this across like your neighborhood and community. And did you know there are even organizations that will come out to you and collect the e-waste and take it away? Post about it. Let me know what you saved from landfill. You can use the hashtag STOP or eCompost.